back to the Elvis Presley Journey. Today we'll be reacting to Elvis, A Generous Heart. I don't think this is a music video. I think this is just a video talking about how generous Elvis was. I think so. So, let's get straight into it.
We were in Jackson, Mississippi, and he got word that a little boy in the hospital was dying, and that he wanted to see Elvis, and he couldn't make it to the show. He was too sick to get to the show, and so we loaded up in cars and we went to the hospital. And Elvis was wearing Elvis met this little boy and talked to him, and he was wearing a cross that was made of garnets. And he took it off and he gave it to this child. And it was a real touching, touching moment, just an hour or so before the show.
When my wife was, 9 or 10, and her sister was maybe a couple years older than that, they would go down to Graceland and in the hopes of seeing Elvis. And they would go down there almost every weekend, Saturday or Sunday, and many times he would actually come down to the gate and shake hands and talk to people, and he did it often. Sometimes he did it by himself. Sandra remembers one time he actually came down riding a horse and was talking to him, and that just made their day, you know, and it just, again, shows the type of person that he is, that he would do that.
When Elvis started getting that money and it started becoming, he wanted to share it. He was a sharing person. And his dad got in early confrontations with him about giving so much away. He would say, son, you know, we're pretty wealthy. Man, you're giving people houses. And you're giving guys on television, you don't even know, Cadillacs. And people would walk off the street in a dealership, you buy them a Cadillac. And pretty soon, the bank account is going to take a hit. And Elvis would say, look, Dad, he said, look, I enjoy giving stuff away to people. He said, that's how I get my enjoyment. He said, I can go out and do a tour. He said, I can do a tour in 6 weeks and make $2 million.
Who is he?
He said, I'm not worried
about speaking
now. He said, I want to make people happy.
For all of Elvis Presley's accomplishments, I think his greatest joy, other than Lisa Marie, was giving to others. He loved to see the smiles and the looks on people's faces when he gave them things. He really was a generous and kind man.
The true measure of a man's success is not what he achieves and acquires for himself in his lifetime, but what of himself he gives to others. Elvis Presley touched the lives of millions and millions of people the world over. With his music, his movies, and his live performances, Elvis brought joy to the hearts of people everywhere. And even today, over 3 decades after his untimely death, Elvis's music and his legacy continue to have a lasting and profound impact on music and popular culture around the world.
That's true.
And yet, for all Elvis's phenomenal success as an entertainer, perhaps the king's most endearing quality and the greatest of his legacies was his enormous generosity to others who were less fortunate than he was.
That's good.
I always felt like he tried to give back to his fans more than he took from them. And whenever he gave a piece of jewelry away on the, like on the stage, when he'd take off a ring and hand it to a fan.
Yo, those rings were.
It was just an act of love on his part.
Those rings were big as well.
He just loved his fans, and they're what made him. They what made him work, and why he worked. Why he worked so hard was his fans. He loved his fans.
We had a guy in a group named Richard Davis, who was kind of sort of, he'd been with Elvis, he'd been in the Memphis Mafia, he'd been Elvis' stand-in in a bunch of his movies, Memphis guy, was a record promoter, and he was down on his luck. And Elvis heard about it, and he sent for him. He said, Richard, I hear you're down on your luck. And his holidays were approaching. He said, yeah, Elvis. Elvis gave him a brand new Cadillac convertible and 10,000 cash.
Yeah.
He said, maybe this will help you out. And he said, thanks a lot, Elvis.
On March 25th, 1961, Elvis performed a benefit concert at the Block Arena at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. This performance raised over $65,000 toward the building of the USS Arizona Memorial, which was completed the following year. This donation made Elvis Presley the single biggest individual donor to the Pearl Harbor Memorial. In 1975, at a concert in Asheville, North Carolina, Elvis went on stage wearing a huge opal and diamond ring on his finger. This ring was reportedly worth between $35,000 and $40,000. During the concert, Elvis saw a little girl in the front row who was sitting in a wheelchair. He took the ring off his finger and gave it to the little girl. There was no publicity about this, just the enormous satisfaction that Elvis got from seeing the look on the little girl's face. Elvis reportedly bought close to $700,000 worth of jewelry in the last 5 years of his life, most of which he gave away.
I was sitting by the stage, and he came over to me and he says, where's your case? And he's up there singing, you know. Where's your case? And I said, it's right here. He said, set it up here. So I set my case up on the stage, and he just got jewelry out of it, and he was giving it to people on the people on the front row that would, and he was just giving away all this jewelry. The difference in Elvis and everyone else was that he obviously loved his fans. He was so honest. You just didn't doubt that he was pure as a driven snow. He was just a good, good person, and people knew that. His fans knew that.
Elvis's great spirit of generosity, giving, and compassion for those less fortunate than him lives on to this day. Former wife Priscilla Presley and daughter Lisa Marie Presley continue Elvis's philanthropy and honor his memory through the Elvis Presley Foundation. The foundation supports charities and community programs such as Presley Place, which provides homeless families up to 1 year of rent-free housing, child daycare, career and financial counseling, family management guidance, and other assistance to help people regain their independence and self-esteem.
I want to do something like that.
In 1983, the Elvis Presley Memorial Trauma Center was established at the Regional Medical Center in Memphis. It has served over 80,000 level 1 trauma patients from a 6-state area. Indeed, there is no greater gift one person can give another in this world than to give of himself. And for all Elvis has given the world through his incredible
The leg moves are sick.
His greatest legacy to his millions and millions of fans was his kindness and his generous heart.
He liked to see the enjoyment. Because when a guy gives you a new Cadillac or gives you a house or gives you a free trip to Hawaii, you become elated. And that made him feel good. He didn't play golf, he didn't fish, he didn't hunt, all that stuff. And to give stuff away and make people happy, that's what he enjoyed.
I'm gonna take that off in case there's copyright. What does the end say? To obtain color, okay. Yeah, just in case there's copyright. I took that off. So all you people are like, there was only 10 seconds left of the video. How come you didn't play? Shut up, bro. I just told you why. Because copyright. When you lot make your own YouTube videos, you'll understand how much of a burden copyright can be. But, man. Yeah, man. I want to do so much when I get money. I love giving stuff to people. I just love giving gifts. I love seeing people smile. And I always wanted to provide like a place for homeless people where they can get back onto their feet. And the fact that they actually showed that you can do that has given me hope. But Elvis, man, good guy. I wonder what his wife are doing now. I wonder what his wife and kids are doing now. Lisa. Was it? I said kids. Is it just one? Sorry, it's just Lisa. I know you lot mentioned that she got married to Michael Jackson. But, so it's just one, yeah? But yeah, I like that video. I wonder what the movie's gonna be about now. Like, I wonder if they're gonna actually capture the essence of Elvis. Cause I'm sure people are going to be very, like, they're gonna critique this movie to the bone. So, you know what I'm saying? I hope they captured the essence of Elvis, which was his generosity. And yeah, man. Good guy. Bye.